now it seems I only turn around and I see you by his side. Oh, I can't believe my eyes today, my darling. It's a bride. Somehow I always knew this day would soon be here. Still I wonder as I look at you, what became of all the years? And no words could ever quite express the way I feel inside. Oh, I can't believe my eyes today.
We are gathered here in the sight of God, and in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, who joined this man and this woman in holy matrimony, which has been sanctioned and blessed by Jesus Christ, and declared to be honorable among all men and women. God saw it that it was not good for man to live alone. He created a woman so that life may be shared. God did not take Eve out of Adam's head that she might rule over him or be superior to him. Nor did God take Eve out of Adam's feet to be trampled upon by him or that she might be lower than him. But God took Eve out of Adam's side that she might be his equal, and from under his arm that she might be protected by him, and from and close to his heart that she might be loved by him. Kabrina and Devon have come at this place to pledge their lives to one another, that life and love may be shared together. Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
We do.
Congregation, please. I exhort you both to enter into this new and holy relationship with reverent thought, honest intention, and in the fear of God, duly considering the purpose for which marriage has been ordained. I want to read from 1 Corinthians chapter 13 that we would all know as the love chapter. If I speak in the tongues of men and of angels, but have not love, I am only a resounding gong and a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and can fathom all the mysteries and all the knowledge, and if I have a faith that can move mountains, but have not love, I am nothing. If I give all I possess to the poor and surrender my body to the flames, but have not love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It is not rude. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrong. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, and always perseveres. Love never fails. But where there are prophecies, they will cease. Where there are tongues, they will be stilled. Where there is knowledge, it will all pass away. For we know in part, and we prophesy in part. But when perfection comes, the imperfect disappears. When I was a child, I talked like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I put childish ways behind me. When I became a woman, I put childish things behind me. Now we see but a poor reflection as in a mirror. Then we shall see face to face. Now I know in part, then I shall know fully, even as I am fully known. And now these three remain, faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love. I require and charge you both in the presence of God and of this congregation that if either of you knows anything to prevent you from being lawfully married, you do now declare it. Isn't silence golden?
I do solemnly declare
that I know not,
that I know not
of any lawful impediment,
of any lawful impediment, why I, Devon Patrick Scott, may not be joined in matrimony
to Kabrina Christine Duquette.
I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare
that I know not.
That I know not
of any lawful impediment.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why I, Kabrina Christine Duquette.
Why I, Kabrina Christine Duquette,
may not be joined in matrimony.
May not be joined in matrimony
to Devon Patrick Scott.
To Devon Patrick Scott.
Devon, will you take Kabrina to be your wife, to live according to God's law in holy matrimony? Will you love her, comfort, honor, and sustain her as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Kabrina, will you take Devon to be your husband, to live according to God's law in holy matrimony? Will you love him, comfort, honor, and sustain him as long as you both shall live?
I will.
You have been my voice of reason, my support, and my guidance. Ever since the day we have met, I have been blessed with your love. There has never been a day where I felt alone or forgotten. And I stand here today as a man of few and simple words. And with these few and simple words, I promise to love you with all my heart, to support you in every way possible, and to be there for you in every way that you've been there for me. My love for you will be forever lasting, so long as I have a heartbeat in my chest and air in my lungs. You are the love of my life, my best friend, and my missing piece of this puzzle we call life. As we both stand here, family and friends, I can't help but feel blessed and overjoyed that I'm standing here at the altar with you. I have never been so lucky.
My heart's not sappy. Let's see if we can get through this. Devon, when I was a little girl, I always dreamed of finding a prince. My knight in shining armor. Someone to sweep me off my feet with romance, charm, wit, and plenty of heart. Instead, I fell in love with you, the person I needed. Someone to encourage me to experience the world around me. Someone to help ground me when I became overwhelmed. To support me in every decision I make. I may want something, but you give me exactly what I need. I don't know when I started having feelings for you. Was it when I was looking forward to talking to you and only you on MSN? Or was it sitting beside you, talking to you constantly? I do remember when I realized this feeling. It was when we were at a youth group event, snow tubing. During the ride back home, the song Forever by Chris Brown started playing. As being teenagers, we sang at the top of our lungs. I was sitting beside you, and you happened to look over at me and started singing to me. I don't know if it was you trying to sing to me or if it was just my hopeless romantic brain thinking you were, but I got butterflies in my stomach, and that's when I knew I was falling for you. And even when we were apart, feeling subsided but didn't go away, when we started talking again, those feelings grew with each day. don't remember how or when I started loving you, but I know that every day I am with you, my love grows. Our relationship has not been easy. With every obstacle we face, now and in the future, I promise I will support you with your dreams. I promise to have adventures with you, to work through every problem we have with an open mind. And finally, I promise to love you every day for the rest of our lives.
I call upon these persons here present.
I call upon these persons here present.
To witness that I, Devon.
To witness that I, Devon.
Do take thee, Kabrina.
Do take thee, Kabrina.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To add and to hold.
To add and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and cherish.
Till death us do part.
To death us do part.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
And this I declare upon my honor.
This I declare upon my honor.
I call upon these persons here present.
I call upon these persons here present.
To witness that I, Kabrina.
To witness that I, Kabrina.
Do take thee, Devon.
Do take thee, Devon.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death do us part.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
And this I declare upon my honor.
And this I declare by my honor.
In marriage, rings are often exchanged, and whether they are simple or eloquent in design, the symbolism associated with them is great. A wedding ring is, of course, a universal sign to the outside world that the wearer is committed to another. To the individual, the ring provides a tangible reminder of the marriage union and the promises that have been made. The rings that you bring here today are, in many ways, representative of the very nature of love and marriage. Made in a circle, their design tells us that love must never come to an end. It must always be continuous. The rings will not always shine as brightly as they do today. Like the marriage relationship, they are subject to the wear and tear of daily life. From time to time, they must be cleaned and polished, just as from time to time, the marriage relationship must be refreshed and renewed. Kabrina and Devon, as you exchange these rings today, may you be aware that in your life together, you will go through many cycles. This is just the beginning of a long journey. As you go through life together, remember that your love for each other and your commitment to one another are never ending. They are rare and precious and will sustain you throughout the journey ahead.
We have a double 007 agent with us that has been keeping the rings under lock and key, private. Reminded me who owns what ring.
Oh.
We did that one. I put this ring upon your finger.
I put this ring upon your finger.
As a continual sign that we are married.
As a continual sign that we are married.
Upon the solemn promises we have made this day.
Upon the solemn promises we have made this day.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
A little sweaty,
so. Extra. Force. I put this ring upon your finger.
I put this ring upon your finger.
As a continual sign that we are married.
As a continual sign that we are married.
Under the solemn promises.
Under the solemn promises.
We have made this day.
We have made this day.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
It's going to take some work.
When it's on, it's on. You just remember what I said. When it's on, it's on. Let us pray together. Our God, our Father, giver of grace and wisdom, set your seal upon this solemn act. Give your blessing to Devon and Kabrina as they stand at the threshold of a new and holy relationship. Help them, Lord, to keep the sacred promises that they have made this special day. Grant that they may ever love you and live in peace and harmony, and that in all circumstances they may seek first your kingdom. This we ask through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of God, I declare you to be husband and wife, whom God has joined together. Let no man put asunder. Now, my friend, you kiss your beautiful, beautiful daughter.
No doubt in my mind.
Mr. Devon and Mrs. Kabrina Scott.
For the rest of your days. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Megan. I'm the maid of honor. Okay, so first off, I'd like to thank you all for sharing this day with the bride and groom. Sharing a day of happiness and joy and love. I remember when I first met Kabrina, we were in our public school washroom, and we got talking about our siblings, and that's how our friendship began. Kabrina and I have been making memories together for many years, all the while believing that love can conquer all. And today, I think we've gotten to witness all that in its purest form. Devon, I may not know you as well as I know Kabrina, but any memories that we've shared together are near and dear to my heart. And I look forward to making more memories with you guys as a married couple. So I've seen you guys transform from shy crushes into husband and wife. I have faith that the two of you will work together to conquer anything life throws your way. I hope that you both take time to enjoy and appreciate the little things that life gives you. I hope you take time to relax when things are stressful. I hope you look at each other for the rest of your life with the same love and affection that you guys look at each other with. But for the rest of the evening, I hope for good times, happiness, lots of dancing, lots of smiles, and lots of kissing. So we need more singing to go along with that. Other than that, I love you both, and I hope for nothing but the best for you.
But before I start my speech, I'd like to thank everybody for coming tonight. An absolute pleasure to see so many people. It really means a lot to Devon and Kabrina. I plan on making this speech as long as possible, while considering it's the last day I'm going to see my friend Devon, before his wife steals him away from me. Yeah, come at me, bro. But I'm a nice guy, so I'll try and keep it short. I found this very difficult to make a best man speech. I've known Devon for over 12 years now. Well, tolerated. It's very difficult to condense his life onto a piece of paper. There's been so many adventures we've gone on. They first bonded in high school, back in grade 9. I heard somebody blasting Rammstein from across the class. At the time, I didn't know anybody would like that, apart from Devon. So I immediately ran across the school. I said, Devon, yes, do you like Rammstein? I said, yes. And maybe we became friends afterwards. And over the years I've known Devon, we've made some ups and downs on our friendship. He's helped me through some tough times, actually. But his loyalty.
Stop it.
I need to live with therapy, please. But his loyalty as a good friend.
You can keep it.
But his loyalty as a good friend never faded. Alright, that's enough about complimenting Devon. I gotta compliment somebody else tonight. I was planning on being the best looking person ever tonight. Evidently I failed, because Kabrina has shown me how it's done. Wouldn't you agree, folks? Oh, and of course, the bridesmaids are looking amazing too. Love you. How did you get the groomsmen? They're looking better than we did in the bachelor party, at least. So before I end my speech, I'd like everybody to get your drinks ready. End with a quote and a toast, please. They say, you don't marry the person you can live with. You marry the person you can't live without. I believe this sums up Devon and Kabrina perfectly. Devon and Kabrina, may your marriage be filled with love and laughter, and this be the continuation of a great romance. Here's to the newlyweds. Cheers.
Cheers.
Can I add, I had nothing to do with it. Even though we're related, I had nothing to do with it.
I may not be married after I finish this speech.
Uh-oh, Mike.
Devon. Seeing I've got my missus standing here beside me, I now have to behave. I had a wonderful speech for you, and I've decided to bite my tongue and be the perfect husband that I am.
Thanks. Leading by example, right?
Yeah, exactly. But there's so many things I want to bring up with you, and the fact of welcoming you to our family is something that I cannot do. Devon, you've already been part of our family. You have been. But officially, in front of all the witnesses, welcome to our family. Sorry, I just put you through that little bit of... Now, what do you expect from the father-in-law? Welcome to the family, Devon. My wife and I, and the rest of our family. Get over here.
I'm the mother of the groom, I'm Kim. Thank you, everyone, for celebrating this special night with us. Devon, if I have not told you enough, I will tell you now. You were the best son I could have been. Even as a child, I knew you would be an amazing person. While it has not always been easy for you, I knew that I would not have to worry about it. I am truly happy that you have found happiness with Kabrina, and that you continue to do so with love and respect for each other. And never discount laughter. I find that the most important thing in marriage, any relationship. You both have a lifetime ahead of you, and I couldn't be more glad. Thank you for making me a part of this special day.
Sit back to back, take their shoes off. Devon, you're gonna swap a shoe with your wife. Get used to that, calling her your wife. All right, so they look a little similar, but Devon is not wearing the high heels. That's Kabrina.
Not this time.
That was the bachelor party. All right. So I'm gonna ask you both a series of questions, and based on who best fits the answer, don't look at the other person, no peeking, but raise the shoe of whoever best fits the answer. So for example, if I ask the two of you who currently has the most cash on them, whose shoe would you lift?
It's my money, but he has it.
It's my money, that's right. So that's both Devon. Actually, Devon, tell you what, I'm gonna get you to swap shoes in your hands just so that we're clear on who's who, so that if they're raising the same side, that's the same person. But if it's a different side, it's a different person. All right, so I'm gonna start asking a series of questions. I had a list, but Kabrina added some questions in here. Maybe you could guess which ones are hers. Anyway, first question, between the two of you, who is the biggest flirt?
He said you could say
that. That's better. All right, they're agreeing. We're good. All right, when you first started dating, who made the first move? Devon, again, two for two. Between the two of you, who is the better cook? All right, next question. Who said I love you first? There you go. Who has the better looking family? Alright, Devin with some brownie points there. Alright, who has the wackiest family?
Yeah,
Kabrina. They're proud of it too. First ones to get cut off tonight. Who's the better driver? Who's more stubborn?
Yeah. Put yourself.
Yeah, there we go. Come on.
Come on, you know. Okay, who has the final say? Who spends the most time on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram? Kabrina. Who's most likely to yell at a telemarketer? Devin, there you go. Who spends the most time in front of a mirror? She's thinking about it. Alright, Kabrina. Who's the bigger baby when they get sick? Devin, hands down. Who's in control of the checkbook? Kabrina. Who wears the pants in the family? Kabrina. Who will be doing most of the yard work? Devin. If you haven't already, who's most likely to pass gas in front of the other? But they both claim themselves, that's weird. Alright. Now that you're married, who will be the first to say, not tonight? Devin. Sorry, pal. Who snores the most? Devin. Who has the best taste in music? Disney doesn't count. It's close though. Devin told me to say that. Who will be the first to fall asleep tonight? We'll see. Who has the smelliest feet? Just checking his shoes. Who popped the question?
I brought it up, but he popped the question.
Uh-oh. Gotta talk that one out. Alright, who's most likely to get lost? Right. Who's most likely to ask for directions? Kabrina. Who's the first one to make up after a fight?
Devin.
Come on, Kabrina. Who started that fight?
Probably.
Yeah. Who's most likely to wake up grumpy in the morning? Devin. Who's most likely to wake up hungover in the morning? Devin. Kabrina. Back and forth. Alright, last question. Who do you love most in the whole entire world? Alright, there you have it. Nice try, Devin. I'm going to pass it back off to Uncle George. Thank you very much.
Sabrina! What? Both of you put Devin's shoes on.
I was saying the same. Devin loves Devin and so does Sabrina.
Throw him under the bus. Jeez. He's your bro.
I like his style.
Yeah.
Your shoe?
Yeah, your shoe's up there.
Yeah, he held up her shoe.
Alright, you're going to need your shoes for this next thing. We're going to have a dance battle. No, I'm kidding.
Solo battle.
That's later.
Aww. Why don't you do it now?
Thanks, Adrian. Do you want to do this?
You're good.
Yeah.
I don't take your job.
Okay, thanks. You're already doing it. We almost sat here away. So we need to clear these chairs away because we're going to do some dancing now.
Ooh, yeah!
Thank you, buddy.
Good job, I think. Good job. Good. All right, we're all set. Okay, so we're going to have our, as it says here, traditional dance. So up first will be the bride and her father.
Yay!
Take it away.
You got Kleenex?
She spins and she swings to whatever song plays without a care in the world. And I'm sitting here wearing the weight of the world on my shoulders. It's been a long day and there's still work to do. She's pulling at me saying that I need you. There's a bar I can cancel. So I dance with Cinderella while she's here in my arms. Cause I know something the prince never knew. I dance with Cinderella. I don't want to live to see one once more.
Every year passing,
Take it away, Josh.
We got to do it together. Ready? Are we ready? In 5, 4, 3, 2. Wait a minute. I think we're going to switch this up a little. Boys, what have you on the dance floor, please?